is one of the quietest rooms in the world. Known as an anechoic chamber, it's perfectly designed to remove sound reflections and echo. As well as one of the loudest rooms in the world, the reverberation chamber. I wanted to do a couple tests to compare this room to the reverberation room. For fun, here's the direct comparison.
Today I'm going to show you why thunder proves the dome above us. Thunder needs to hit a solid object to occur. You can't have a thunder without a starting point. This is easy to demonstrate. Here is a good example of what I mean.
I first bring out my Van de Graaff generator, then fill a bottle with water. I then place that on top of the Van de Graaff generator. I turn the Van de Graaff on, and this happens.
The sound of the thunder proves that there is a dome above us, because thunder doesn't produce multiple explosions, rather it produces one explosion sound. They call the thunder sound a thunderclap. This is because it sounds like a clap, but that clap has echo to it which make it sound like multiple sounds. In order to have an echo, you'll need to be inside a closed area, because sound waves needs to hit an object for an echo to occur. Here is a video of a guy blowing a balloon inside a nuclear power plant. When slowed down, it sounds just like thunder. Light travels much faster than sound waves. That's why we see lightning occurs before the thunder sound. There are so many evidence for the dome. Sun, dogs, rainbows, thunder are some of the ones that prove the firmament above us. The Earth is flat, closed, and stationary. Space is fake. Thank you for watching. Please share this video so more people know about this.
Where is the curvature? Where? No curvature.